Sir, plastic packaging has a negative impact on the environment, sir. What are the various ways by which this negative impact can be converted into the positive effect, sir?
See, one of the things that we have to remember that plastic is a wonderful material. A lot of the things that we do today, we cannot do without plastic. Plastic has changed our life. Now, what we need to understand is how do we handle this material? So once we understand that what are we supposed to do with this material after we've done using the product inside it, that is the key to understanding what the impact will be on the environment. So from that perspective, we need to understand, like recycling in India is already pretty high. For plastic recycling is over 63%. That's, on a global scale, that's pretty advanced. But the problem we face is on the smaller sachets and smaller packages that are not properly disposed and are not properly collected. So if we take care of those issues in India, that'll take care of a big portion of our plastic waste. So companies like ours have started to do collection of these packages. So we get these packages collected, we get them cleaned, and then we recycle them into plastic granules. So they can be, other products can be made from it.
Single-use plastic is coming into the ban, and in coming time, it's hardly to see the any single-use plastic. So what are the preparation of Paharpur packaging to launch this kind of packaging, sir, which is 100% biodegradable, sir?
So we do have products available today with Paharpur that are biodegradable. So the problem is not having those products. The problem is the cost of those products. So those products are so expensive that they are not economically feasible. So a product, for example, if you are buying a packet of biscuits today for 5 rupees and you use our biodegradable laminates to package this package of biscuit, it could cost you 500 rupees. So the cost is not feasible at this point in time. So as the technology evolves and develops, we hope that the raw material that we require for the production of these biodegradable laminates will go down.
Paharpur uses various kind of papers. What are the negative and positive impact do you see on paper packaging if paper is supplied from the Indian origin?
We actually are not a large user of paper, so our use of paper or paperboard is mostly for secondary packaging purposes. So the boxes that we pack our products in are paperboard products.
Any product which are going to launch which has a 100% biodegradable, any product? Because nowadays the government is saying you cannot use the PET coating also. You have to use the water coating. The product should be 100% biodegradable. This is a very good demand. All the product is costly, but the later time it may be some cost reductions there. So Paharpur, is any planning to launch this kind of 100% biodegradable product in food and non-food applications?
Like I mentioned, we over the last 4 years, we have developed this product. So we have done shelf life studies, we have done commercial studies with our customers, we packed their products and then done shelf life studies. So we have a successful, fully developed product which is biodegradable. But like I said, it requires films that are biodegradable, and those films are steeply expensive, and that's really what makes the whole project unviable. So until such time that we have these other alternate materials, for example, resin from vegetarian material, from the plants and so on and so forth, those type of technologies need to evolve even more or a lot faster for 100% biodegradable plastic packaging.
in packaging, what global trend do you see which are yet to come to India?
Well, India is pretty advanced in packaging trends, and believe it or not, you know, India has itself set a lot of standards, which at least I see packaging in India far advanced compared to even some North American and European countries. So if you do a apple-to-apple comparison of a lot of products, our products are far superior. Then we have in India products such as refill pouches. You know, when you buy a Kisan 1 liter pack or a Lifebuoy hand wash 1 liter pouch. Those are all refill packs, and you do not need to then buy a very expensive glass bottle or PET bottle, and it replaces them. Now, that concept has not even come into the fore in United States yet. So India is making a lot of progress in certain areas. Now, one thing that we get hindered by is the cost. So a lot of the research and development that goes into packaging, the consumer is not willing to pay for some of those. Like I said, even in biodegradable technologies, the consumer is not there yet where they're willing to pay for the new technological developments. So time, it will take time, but I see a lot of good things actually going from India to other countries. You know, they will start looking at our technology and the things, you know, how we have done source reduction, how we have done recycling of plastic. Our rates are 63%. In US, rate of recycling for plastic is less than 30%. So now they don't litter, you know, they don't throw it on the street. They just throw it in the land, you know, and they dump it, and it's properly taken care of. But the percentage is less than 30% compared to our 63% recycling rate. You will not find as much PET bottles or other plastic materials in India littered on the street. You will not, you know, they properly get taken care of. India has a whole tradition of recycling. Newspaper, you remember when we were growing up, even all the newspapers, you know, there would be a guy come who will buy the newspaper for you, from you. You would put the PET bottle separately in the bag or something, and the guy will come buy the bottles from you. So recycling in India is decades old, you know, from a long time ago. And it has a much higher percentage of recycling than a lot of the advanced countries. But, you know, we need to control our litter problem.
If we see the all grade of packaging, and what is the contribution of paper substrates in packaging? What's the percentage? And what appreciation you do see in paper-based packaging coming 5 years, sir?
Like I said, we don't use a lot of paper in our packaging. Yeah, in general, sir. But even in India, paper is got a very small percentage of packaging. Now, in developed countries, you see a lot more share of paper packaging. You know, in North American countries and in European countries, you see paper being a larger part of packaging. Matter of fact, we, you know, for the fast food industries, for example, if you go to McDonald's and Burger King's and in US, you would see they have more paper-based wrappers and boxes and cardboards. They have eliminated a lot of foil, paper, and other materials. And the good thing about paper is that, you know, if properly used, it is 100% sustainable. So if you cut down 4 trees and you plant 5 trees, you can have, you know, unlimited supply of paper, and you're not going to hurt the environment. But the key there is, you know, it's the cycle has to be in the closed loop. So if you cut 4, you have to plant 5.
What any research you are doing which will be beneficial for the packaging industry, sir?
Like I said, we do continue to do a lot of R&D with packaging material. We continue to find newer and innovative ways of interacting with our consumer. You know, so not with our customers, but with our consumers. So how can we make their life easier? You know, our vision of our company is to make the life better for our consumers, the end users, so that people in smaller villages have access to a lot of these products because of our packaging, which they wouldn't. So based on that vision, you know, we continue to put a lot of effort in developing new technologies. Some of them, you know, we patent our technologies every year, several patents a year. That allows our customer to advance their products to our consumers. So I can talk about, you know, only a handful, but you know, some of the technologies and developments are because they're proprietary in nature, so I cannot discuss them, you know, individually.
What is the worth of packaging market in India, sir? And what appreciation do you see in next decade, sir?
The Indian packaging market is over $20 billion. $20 billion. You know, it's huge. Now, flexible is a smaller portion of it, but Indian packaging has not even touched. You know, most of the product are still unpacked. If you look at it, the packed versus unpacked, we've got probably a ratio of 65 to 35. 65% products are still unpacked. So the packaging has a huge ways to evolve in India. You know, for the next several decades, you know, we will. If we just all we did was convert the unpackaged products into packaged products, this industry will have double-digit growth for the next 30, 40 years.
Any collective effort on the behalf of packaging association just to enhance the packaging in the on the product?
A lot of social activity that happens. The logo ko jagruk karna ke jo packaging aap kar rahe hain is that you know, we go to these little places where we talk to the farmers, where we talk to the co-op people and talk to them about how they are processing their food, how they're transporting their materials. Milk, for example, we waste 40. We waste more milk in India than the entire European countries produce. Jitna wo log banate nahi hain, usse zyada hum waste karte hain. And that gets wasted because the point from where it's the milk is taken from the cow or the animal to the local collection point to the refrigeration point, half of it has already gone bad. And then, you know, so the supply chain is and the packaging is so inferior that it you know, we waste more than 40% of our produce, green vegetables and fruits. We're largest producers in some of those. So what we do is Paharpur, for example, has partnered with Indian Institute of Packaging for the last 20 years. And we bring the students to our factory. We show them, we make them aware of what's going on with the new technologies. Then we would go with the institute to all these remote places and make sure that, you know, we're conveying to them what the packages are available. We would work with different boards, you know, like for example tea board, you know, so converting their tea products from gunny sacks into proper packaging so that it can retain its aroma and fragrance. So those type of grassroots efforts are continuing and they're going on, and you see the difference, you know.
What do you want to say to the paper industry in context of technically and commercially viability of the paper?
Well, my in my earlier days, you know, I did a lot of paper packaging, you know, and you know, in India, like I said, there's not a lot of products that are paper packaged. You know, paper is a great packaging material. You know, it's got a lot of benefits and characteristics, and our key issue there is that we need to make sure that we as users continue to be sustainable, right? So if we don't end up eliminating rainforests for the paper, you know, so we need to make sure that our recycling rates are high, we're ensuring that our replantation rates are high. So for example, even in our company, you know, every year we have a target that every year we are going to plant 50 new trees, you know, and so we don't cut down any trees, but we continue to add 50 trees every year. And those type of efforts need to be there, done by the paper industry on an aggressive front, that to ensure that we're not depleting the resources. We're actually adding to the resources. If we do that, paper is a fantastic material for packaging.